Welcome to Cologne. On behalf of Bio-Rad, I'm proud to open the fourth convention on quality control at European level. We try to select 11 hot topics on quality control to develop together along with outstanding international speakers, followed by some interactive question and answer. And now I introduce the Master of Ceremony, Max Williams, which is our Global Marketing Manager, which will introduce all the speakers. I wish you a nice day in Cologne and a very pleasant participation. Good work to everybody. Max, the stage is yours now.
Okay. Thank you. Thank you. Welcome, everybody. Welcome to Cologne for our fourth convocation of experts in laboratory quality. We're really happy to have you here. One moment. Really happy to have you here. This is a new format for us this year. In the past, we've had working groups. This year, we're taking the synthesis of the work from the past 3 years and trying to present perspectives, and we hope that you will all share in this with us. A few things. It's a really unique opportunity for you to share and learn. And you've been selected because of your passion for quality in the laboratory. And we really embrace that, and we thank you for being here. Your participation is essential. I know it. There will be speakers, 22 speakers, over the next 2 days, so we have a packed agenda. Some of the topics may be something that you have always been interested in but haven't been able to learn enough about. Remember that in our time together, there are no right answers. These are perspectives and opinions. I will say mostly there are no right. There's a few, but you'll see as those come across. Your voices will be heard, and we really request your input. We're going to have opportunity for discussion, and we'd like to get your perspective as you work in the laboratory. The agenda today, presentations and discussion up until around 12:50. We'll have lunch, continue the presentations and discussion, followed by a social dinner and tour this evening. And you'll see in your programs that we're broken into different languages based on the tour guide and touring groups. We'll continue tomorrow and early in the day, around 2:30 at the end of lunch. So these are the hot topics. These are the subject areas that we've selected for this year. This really is a synthesis of the last few years of the work that we've done together. And there's an evolution, and we'll talk about that on Wednesday. We'll show you some history of some polling that we did 3 years ago and some polling that we'll do today, and we'll see how perceptions have changed. It's kind of exciting for us. In your hands or at your desk, you have a small polling device. And we'll take a few minutes and do some sample questions. And this is kind of fun. A number of you have used these in the past. It's anonymous data, but we want to get your opinions on these things and use it to spark some discussion. One important thing is this is not a test or a review of the material that you've seen. This is not saying how well did you pay attention, how well did you listen, et cetera. It's really about your opinion or what you're doing in your laboratory. And we hope that it will spark some discussion. Please remember to return your device at the end of the day today. There's 76 of you with devices in the room. So when we do the questions, we'll see a meter going about up to 76. So again, we thank you for being here and look forward to your participation. First question. What is Eau de Cologne? You can answer multiple times until it closes. The very last answer that you input on your device is the one that will be selected for you. My preference would be, oh, very good. I was going to say number two. I'm in the company of 1% there. Okay, very good. So I think we have the idea on this one. Turns out the correct answer is perfume. Very good. That's good. How high is the Kölner Dome? One holdout? Still thinking? Aha. 37% said 173. Close. It's 157. Okay, a little bit of demographics. Tell us a bit about where you hail and in your laboratory. Public hospital, private hospital and or lab, university and or research center, or other. Okay. 55% public hospital laboratories. Great. Also, just note another just advice from the stand here. We are videotaping the event, and we will later have the video available for you and in various venues. We'll have a handheld mic if you want to ask questions of the speakers and for the discussion, and we ask that you speak into that when we do that. We have Andy in the back who will be helping us answer the questions. Is your lab accredited? Quick answers. Very good. It'll be interesting to compare this. We'll talk about this tomorrow. We'll compare this to the answers from 3 years ago. 59% according to ISO 15189. That is a marked change. Okay? And only 9% are not accredited. Annual test volume in my laboratory is? This is number of examinations. Okay, somebody's shy, a few people shy, don't want to answer. Over a million, so we have large laboratories represented here. Good volume. And last of our demographic question, which best fits your professional background? Now, we argued about this in creating this question. We know that people have a lot, but just pick one that that best fits your professional background. And there is a correct answer here, so. Okay. A few more seconds. Okay, so look around your colleagues, majority clinical chemistry background. But it's good to see we have some others, but very much shifted toward clinical chemistry. So when we get into some of the virology conversations, we hope that our colleagues there will be able to help guide some of that discussion.